American democracy has been stolen. Democracy is supposed to give the people a choice in who governs them. But we don't really have a choice in America anymore. There are just two parties that voters can choose from, and these two parties both take money from corporations. And because these two parties are the rulers of America, and because these two parties have been bought by corporations, we no longer have democracy in America. We have control of government by corporations, and that is fascism. I mean, look what these two parties have done to our country. They've just divided it up amongst themselves into districts so that only one party can win. And when only one party can win in each district, we don't have elections anymore. And look how these parties have governed this country. Under the control of these two parties that often act like one party, we've seen a steady decline in wages and benefits over the last 30 years. We've seen numerous senseless military adventures in the Third World. And we've seen a relaxation of regulations that are meant to protect consumers from corporations. And so America has become, under the governance of these two parties, which are really controlled by corporations, a more warlike nation, a nation that has a greater gap between rich and poor, and a nation in which corporations run amok. And that is what results from these two parties that are controlled by corporations. So if you want real democracy, and if you want real leaders that will put an end to this military adventurism, that will restore democracy, and will regulate these corporations, you cannot restrict yourself to voting for Tweedledee and Tweedledum. So branch out. Vote for third parties. Vote for me, Ralph Nader, a candidate who has always stood by his principles and will continue to do so after his election. Thank you very much.
Excuse me, gentlemen, I've been wondering, who are you?
I believe what is important, sir, is that you would make a foolish prince.
Nay, little more than a bunchback toad is he. He did less for the social theater is he than for a swampy morass.
Does he deserve our aid, good Richard?
Deserve? Less than you know, Benigno, deserve to have been placed in exile. But he needs our philosophies more than I paid for a rear-end arm.
So be it then, that Niccolo Machiavelli and Richard of Gloucester lend their instruction to one Ralph Nader.
Lead on, Toad, to your study before we may retire to speak.
Niccolo Machiavelli? Richard III? Two of the most evil and conniving and murderous bastards in history? Why would I want to have anything to do with your twisted schemes?
I'll have you know, sir, that my theories have been inspired by one of the greatest empires the world has known, the Romans. Not to mention that they've gone on to inspire some of the greatest political thinkers of your time, Henry Kissinger among them.
And need you be told that I, unlike your foolishness, have assumed power before. And lest I belittle my companion, many of his ideas did aid me.
Well, I suppose the old playbook could use a few new tactics.
This way, gentlemen. Have a seat, John.
Much obliged.
Sir,
you two recommend yourselves very highly. What pointers do you have for me?
Thou wilt see more than mere pointers.
You see, Nader, your image, it's all wrong.
What's wrong with my image? Thou art weak.
And too intellectual.
And have lost too many elections.
1996.
2000.
2004.
2008.
Okay. So maybe I haven't been the best politician. But I've stuck to my values and my principles. And that's more important than elections.
You don't get it, do you? In politics, values do not matter. What's important is image, and yours is lacking.
Well, who do you want to be like? George Bush?
Thou can learn much from George Bush.
Bush may have made some mistakes. Hiring mercenaries. Appointing fools. But he knew how to tell the American people what they wanted to hear. He knew how to be the leader that they wanted. Bush made people feel comfortable by acting like a regular person rather than a member of the ruling class. He made good use of symbols, the church, the military, institutions that people trusted. Bush appeared tough and moral, but also like someone you could have a beer with. Precisely what the American people wanted.
Well, I guess I could try to be a little bit more like that. People see me as a Bible candidate.
It is true, you're a Bible candidate, but not leading in the polls.
What? Thou shine bright, but thou must see those who shine brighter as thy enemy.
He speaks the truth, Nader. If you're not in the lead, you may as well not be running.
I'm on the rise, though.
No! 'Tis better to extinguish thy enemy than to shine brighter.
Were you aware, Nader, that President Obama was not born in this nation?
That's not true. He was born in Hawaii.
This certificate shows otherwise.
And Kane has his imperfections to be exploited as well. Thou must see, Nader. Your opponents have Achilles' heels, and the media is your arrow. Expose your opponents as the foreign invaders and lustful pizza men that they are. If we can sully their image, thou can, and thou will, clear a path to thy ascension.
I don't want to be involved in any of that kind of thing.
Thou must remember the slanderous sentiment pressed upon thee when George Bush did usurp the presidency. Spoiler.
'Tis the nature of the game.
I don't have to sink to that level. I'm trying to run a clean campaign here.
None of that will matter unless you win.
What dost thou say?
Fine, we'll do it.
Joining us now on the phone is Michael Weldon, who's a board-certified forensic document examiner. Thank you for joining us, sir. I know you're in the middle of Texas somewhere, couldn't get to a studio, but tell us, can you 100% surely, definitively tell us that this is President Obama's, Barack Hussein Obama's original birth certificate?
I don't find, right off the top, I don't find any real smoking gun, as in something like a Microsoft Word font that appeared. It's likely that this is it says on it that it is a certified true copy.
The controversy surrounding his original birth certificate continues to dog his administration.
A new report rocking the campaign of GOP presidential candidate Herman Cain, a report that claims two women accused him of sexual harassment in the 1990s.
What do you think? Do you think Politico was tipped off on this 20-year-old plus story?
Here to set the record straight, 2012 GOP presidential candidate Herman Cain.
Yes, I have never sexually harassed anyone. Let's say that. Secondly, I've never sexually harassed anyone.
Nader, I've been surveying your policies, and I see a number of striking flaws in your military strategy.
What are you talking about? My plan to drastically cut military spending would allow for many more
social programs at home.
That was the man myself?
You must shore your defense in a strong militia. I recommend increasing it by 28 brigades.
Well, spending a few extra troops back home wouldn't hurt. Maybe they could put them to work building wind farms or installing solar panels. They do call Army Green. But what about all these bases abroad? We've got fleets in every single ocean. Surely there's no use for the huge empire. Stop!
You're being recklessly idealistic. We must keep these bases in small colonies because they help exert our influence abroad without the dangers of a large military force.
We think you have forgotten something. I see a large threat nearby.
My fellow Americans, I understand these are crazy times. You just found out that your president was not born here. You just found out that Herman Cain sexually harassed his women. You just found out I exist. And you may be asking yourselves, with the two viable candidates in this race going down in smoke, who is left to vote for? But if you ask yourself that question, then you're asking the wrong question. Because there are three viable candidates in this race. If you elect me to be your commander-in-chief, I will have the fortitude to strengthen us at home, the perseverance to continue our commitments abroad, and the balls to counter any threats that rise over the horizon. But more importantly, I'm just like you. Don't let my suit fool you. Beneath this jacket and tie, I wear a wife beater and drink beer just like you. I even got a DUI once. But most importantly, I understand you. And that is what a true leader truly needs to be able to do, to understand his people. And I can do that. So when you walk into that booth on election day and vote for Ralph Nader, what you're really doing is voting for yourself. And that's all I'm asking of you, America. Vote for yourself. Vote for Ralph Nader. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Goodbye.
Our work here is complete.